Hi, I'm Elaine Mills with Master Gardeners of Northern Virginia, here today to talk about an invasive plant, Liriope. Invasive plants aren't just those that spread aggressively in our own gardens. In fact, invasiveness was defined in two executive orders. The first, signed by President Clinton in 1999, that was later amended by President Obama in 2016. Those documents state that invasive plants are those that are not native to the area in which they are found growing. They can escape from cultivation, either the plants themselves or plant parts, their seeds, their fruit, their roots. And when they do that, they can cause harm either economically, environmentally, or to human, animal, or plant health. There are two species of Liriope, Liriope muscari, which has a more clumping form, and Liriope spicata, which spreads readily by rhizomes. But both of these species can spread when the seeds from this fruit are carried by either birds or animals into natural areas. They will be excreted, and then the plant can spread rapidly, creating a monoculture and suppressing the growth of native plants. Liriope is an extremely popular ground cover, and it's still widely available in the horticulture trade despite being designated as invasive. As I mentioned, Liriope spicata is the more aggressive of the two species. It's differentiated not just by the way it spreads, but also by these long, narrow leaf blades that come to a distinct point. This species spreads so aggressively that it can even travel under a cement sidewalk like this one from one side to the other. In my garden, I've had small root fragments regrow even after 12 years of the original Liriope having been removed. Many people are quick to use a chemical treatment to handle invasive plants, but I would like to recommend the use of two different tools. When dealing with small infestations of individual plants, you might want to use this soil knife, referred to as a hori-hori. With its pointed tip and serrated edge, it's really great at digging in and removing the plant. For a more aggressive infestation, I would recommend this toothed shovel. It can give you a lot of power to reach in and cut through the turf-like roots of Liriope spicata. Luckily, there are some great native plants that make wonderful replacements for invasive Liriope. We're here at the Glen Carlin Library Community Garden to show you three native plants that I think make excellent replacements for invasive Liriope. The first is plantain-leaved sedge, Carex plantagenea. To my mind, this is really the perfect substitute for Liriope. It has a similar clumping habit, it's about the same size, and it has these wide strap-like leaves. With this interesting crinkled texture, this plant is sometimes called seersucker sedge. In the spring, this sedge will send up inflorescences. That's the technical term for flowers. They are on alternating maroon and lime green stalks. Now, this particular plant is wind pollinated, so the pollen from those flowers will not be used by our insect pollinators. But the plant supports wildlife in a couple of other ways. The seeds that develop from those flowers can be eaten by birds, and the leaves serve as nourishment for the caterpillar stage of butterflies. This particular plant prefers to grow in part to full shade. Theoretically, it likes moist to wet soil, but I found that once established, it's done quite well in the dry shade of my own personal garden. The nice thing about this plant is that it will spread, but slowly over time. And you can see how a little offset is forming here. Here are some more on this particular plant. And you can dig those up and then spread them throughout your garden. The second native plant I'd like to recommend as a replacement for liriope is Christmas fern, Polystichum acrosticoides. This plant grows in circular cascading clumps. They're lying down a little bit right now because we're filming in December, but they will remain evergreen, and then they'll be refreshed with new growth when silvery-edged fiddleheads come up in the spring. Christmas fern has dark green, leathery fronds, and you'll note that the pinnae look a little bit like Christmas stockings, giving the plant its common name. This is a non-flowering plant, and it reproduces by spores that are located on the underside of the pinnae. Christmas fern grows in part to full shade in dry to moist soil. It grows in dry shade in my particular garden. This plant is attractive when used individually as an accent plant. You could use a row of Christmas ferns along a path as edging, or you could group them for erosion control on a slope. The third native plant I'm recommending is lyreleaf sage, Salvia lyrata. It's named for the shape of its leaves. They're normally quite a bit more lobed than on this particular specimen, but they make a really nice basal rosette that will remain evergreen through the winter. In the spring, lyreleaf sage will send up flowering stalks. They're square-stemmed because this is a member of the mint family, and the flowers will spiral around the stem, typically mint-like. They are tubular, and they are lavender in color and will draw bees and butterflies for the nectar. When they're pollinated, they will form these ornamental seed heads that attract birds for the seed. Lyreleaf sage grows in full sun to part shade and dry to moist soil. It is drought tolerant once well established. As a member of the mint family, it does like to spread, but it spreads by self-seeding rather than through rhizomes under the ground. You can take advantage of this seeding to allow it to reproduce and create quite a nice dense ground cover. If, on the other hand, you don't like little volunteers coming up, luckily this plant is fairly shallowly rooted, and it's easy enough to dig them up and share with other folks. As I've mentioned, all three of these particular plants I'm suggesting as replacements are evergreen, and I think you'll find them very attractive if you decide to add them to your garden. Whichever of these three native plants you choose as a replacement for invasive liriope, I wish you happy gardening.